I'm Tracy Hyder Suffern, Executive Director of the National Jazz Museum in Harlem. I want to thank each of you, all of you, for dining and being with us here at Jays on the Bay to celebrate the Afro-Latin roots of jazz. This is going to be a great hour for all of you who know you love jazz and all of you who don't know yet that you love jazz too. On behalf of our artistic directors, the amazing Christian McBride and the amazing John Batiste, our board of trustees, and the entire museum staff, welcome to you. Welcome to Latin Bird Crib Collective Concert at Jays on the Bay. This is part of our annual August series celebrating the Afro-Latin roots of jazz and our Charlie Parker Centennial Celebration presented in collaboration with Summer Stage and the Charlie Parker Jazz Festival, and of course, with Jays on the Bay. Charlie Bird Parker is undoubtedly one of the most iconic and significant voices in the story of America, in all of American music and jazz around the world. Bird's contributions as a composer, improviser, and genius forever shifted the trajectory of jazz, and his influences reached and still reach around the world. Bird is known worldwide as a bebop innovator. He also made numerous recordings with the Afro-Latin bands, including Afro-Cuban jazz pioneer Machito. Tonight, it's our pleasure to present to you three bands: Manuel Valera and New Cuban Express, the Ella Brick Quartet, and to close the show, Zakai Curtis and his Afro-Latin Quintet. We asked each band to share with us a set inspired by the great Bird and his explorations of Afro-Latin jazz music. Before that, I'm so happy to introduce our MC for the evening, our colleague and one of the co-founders of the annual New York International Salsa Congress, Vilma Villavicencio.
Hello, Tracy, and thank you for having me tonight at this amazing celebration of Afro-Latin roots of jazz. This music is so close to my heart and to the hearts of all of our friends at the New York International Salsa Congress. The Congress takes place every Labor Day weekend here in New York City, where we spend 3 days of living, breathing, and dancing to salsa and Afro-Latin music. You may have heard that this year we will be postponing the Salsa Congress, and in 2021, we will celebrate the 20th anniversary of this wonderful event. So mark your calendars, September 2nd through the 6th. Visit us at www.newyorksalsacongress.com. Now let's get to the first band of the evening. There is magic in Cuba. There is magic in Cuban music. It makes us move, it makes us think, it makes us want to celebrate, and it makes us joyful. Now, mix that with the energy and excitement of New York City, and you get something extra, extra. Our first artist, Manuel Valera, is a Grammy-nominated pianist, composer, and bandleader, born and raised in Havana, Cuba. He has called New York City his home for over 20 years now. Manuel has worked with musicians including John Patitucci, Antonio Sanchez, James Jenness, Yosvani Taris, Daphnis Prieto, Horacio El Negro Hernandez, and many others. He has received multiple commissions from Chamber Music America and a 2019 Guggenheim Fellowship. He was also nominated for a 2013 Grammy in the Best Latin Jazz Album of the Year category. Tonight, Manuel and his band, New Cuban Express, will share with you their Latin Bird-inspired performance. In addition to Manuel on piano, you will hear Felipe Lamoglia on tenor saxophone, Ricky Rodriguez on bass, Jimmy McBride playing drums, and Samuel Torres holding down percussion. Please welcome Manuel Valera and New Cuban Express. Thank you.
Thank you. That was Manuel Valero with Felipe Lamoglia, Ricky Rodriguez, Jimmy McBride, and Samuel Torres, who were absolutely amazing. Thank you, everyone. And thank you, everyone, for being here with us. I already welcomed all of you to the music this evening. Now I welcome you to one of my favorite restaurants in the whole world. And I'm here with some of my favorite people. I'm live at a watch party for tonight's Crib Collective Latin Bird concert. Joe Salameni is the owner of Jay's on the Bay. This is a gourmet diner and eatery located at 1189 Bay Street on Staten Island, 2 minutes from the Verrazano Bridge and 2 minutes from the Staten Island Ferry. Joe and his staff have been, I eat here five times a week, by the way. Joe and his staff have been kind enough to host this watch party for tonight's performances. I'm here with all of them, with all of the folks eating who are behind me eating. And I'm here at the Jay's on the Bay backyard with all of you. When you're in Staten Island, I ask you to come and try the chicken and waffles. I'm vegetarian and I eat the chicken and waffles once a week because it's the truth. Seriously, you have to try it. Right? It's delicious, right? And so, Joe, let me ask you, let's get you here in the camera. Why did you decide to host this with us tonight? Okay, sorry. Live TV. It's the 50s.
Decided to be here with you guys tonight because, just like music, cooking has to do with the soul. So they go hand in hand.
We're really grateful. And tell us a little bit about the restaurant, about the food here.
So we're a new American restaurant. Concept came because Staten Island's predominantly a lot of Italian eateries, and I wanted to bring something different to Staten Island.
So here we are. And tonight we have live music. And we have you. So enjoy the rest of the performances.
Thank you for being here.
Tracy, that looks like so much fun. We'll have to meet up for dinner there sometime. Now for our next performance. Linda Briseño, also known as Ella Brick, is a name you need to know, period. A native of Caracas, Venezuela, Briseño grew up studying classical percussion and trumpet at the world-renowned El Sistema program, whose alumni include Gustavo Dudamel and Pedro Estache. In 2013, she relocated to New York City to study at the New School and quickly made her mark on the music scene as a trumpeter, singer, songwriter, band leader, and producer. In fact, she has already received 3 Latin Grammy nominations, and in 2018, she won her first Latin Grammy as a producer for the album Segundo Piso, by the artist MC Caldera. With this win, Briseño became the first female ever to win a Latin Grammy for Best Producer. Ella Brick is a rare breed of musicians that is 100% comfortable in any musical environment, from jazz to pop and everything in between. Please enjoy this performance by the Ella Brick Quartet featuring Daniel Prim and Franco Lemus on percussion, Freddy Adrian Gonzalez on bass, our band leader, Linda Briseño, on trumpet, and special guest, Otmaro Ruiz, playing the Fender Rhodes. And as an added bonus, keep your eyes peeled for our friends, Melanie Torres and Gabriel Perez from Dance on Sioux Studios, who will share with you a special salsa presentation. Thank you, Ella Brake. And weren't Melanie and Gabriel amazing? Don't worry, they're coming back in the next act. Speaking of the next act, have you heard of Donald Harrison, Cindy Blackman Santana, Eddie Palmieri, Christian Scott, Ray Vega? I'm sure many of you have heard of these jazz stars. Well, each one of them formed bands that included the next performer, pianist Zakai Curtis. Zakai is a band leader, producer, and pianist with 5 albums as a leader and over 20 years as a sideman. Always composing for his groups, Zakai was presented with a composition award from the Connecticut Commission on Culture. And in 2017, he received a grant from Chamber Music America's New Jazz Works program. Zakai and Luke formed a recording collective, Truth Revolution Records, that supports musicians recording and releasing albums on their own terms as an alternative to the bigger record labels. And on this label in 2017, Zakai produced Andy Gonzalez's album, Entre Colegas, which was nominated for a Grammy Award. For the final set tonight, please enjoy Zakai Curtis and his Afro-Latin quintet featuring Willie Martinez on timbales, Camilo Molina on congas, Reynaldo de Jesus on bongos, Luke Curtis on bass, and Zakai Curtis on piano and arrangements. Oh, and our friends Melanie and Gabriel are back.
Thank you.
Well, everyone, that's it for this year's Latin Bird Crip Collective Concert. We want to thank all three bands for joining us in this celebration of the Afro-Latin roots of jazz. I'll pass it back to Tracy, and I hope to see you at the 2021 New York International Salsa Congress in the heart of Times Square.
Vilma, thank you so much. You've been so incredible tonight, and we're so appreciative of everything you've done to make tonight so beautiful. I want to say I'm so looking forward to celebrating with you next year at the New York International Salsa Congress here in New York over Labor Day weekend. I'll also say that anyone who dances or anyone who likes to dance or anyone who likes to hear live Latin music should also be at the New York International Salsa Congress in 2021 over Labor Day weekend. All of us want to thank all of you for being here with us tonight. It was a beautiful night. Everyone was so incredible. I want to thank you for always supporting the National Jazz Museum in Harlem. If you'd like to donate, please go to www.jmih.org/donate, or right now you can pick up your telephone and you can text the word jazz, J-A-Z-Z, to the number 41444. I've already said thank you to everyone, but I do want to thank again every musician, every artist who performed tonight. Thank you so much. We love working with you so much. I want to say thank you to Jays on the Bay. I want to say thank you to the incredible National Jazz Museum staff. I want to thank everybody here who joined us tonight. I want to say special thanks to Martin Mejia, who's been here with me, and he's been coaching us through all of these things. Remember, if you'd like to donate, text the word jazz to text the word jazz to 41444, or go to jmih.org/donate to contribute. Your gifts will go directly towards supporting artists like the ones you've seen tonight. Every penny goes towards keeping an artist working. That's our promise to you. That's us, everyone. Thank you and have a wonderful evening.